Today I'm going to show you an easy way how to create rain in a photo. Hello my friends, and let's get started. So this is our end result, and this is the picture that we are starting with. You can see it's wet, but there's no rain in the picture, and I'm going to show you a very easy way how to create that in a realistic looking fashion. So I delete that, the rain that I've created, and now we have just the picture. So first thing we're going to do is a new layer, and then we're going to go up here to filters, noise, and then to Perlin noise, and you create noise kind of nice and how to say, small noise, not too big, not like this, very small noise like this is fine. Apply to create it, and then go up here again to blur and use motion blur. So that's important. And you want to hold the shift key because this is jumping in 45 degree angle. So when you have the shift key, you can move it freely, and you want to apply it in a fashion that is useful for your rain depending on how extreme the weather is. So right now I'm using 80 degrees. We click apply. And then we need to create some adjustment layers. So the next one here, adjustment layer, the first one we want to create is curves. And we create it and then pull it down onto the picture so it's like this. And set the layer of the noise, of the rain, to screen as a blend mode so you can see what you're doing. Now you can see it's blended onto the picture, but it's still much too extreme. So next thing we want to do, double click on your curve adjustment and then pull these sides in until you reach a level where it feels fine to you. Pull it in from both sides, and you can see that you can create just a little bit of rain. You can create really a lot of rain, but of course the rain drops, the rain streaks shouldn't be too big, too extreme. So maybe something like this is a good idea. That looks okay like this. You can even move this over. You can see it gets thinner a little bit. And the next thing I want to do is go down here to live filters and select again motion blur. I want to have a little bit more motion in this. So set the radius. You can see it's moving, but I wouldn't set it to the same angle as your rain is. I would set it to a little bit of a different angle. So maybe let's try 40 degrees looks good, but you can just try around with that, what looks good to you, also with the setting on how strong the motion blur is, which is very much depending also on the mood in the picture. But we are not done yet, because rain is made of water, of course, and water has an effect on light, so it can't be spread throughout the picture in the same way. So what we want to create is that the rain is influenced by the highlights in the picture. So the way we are going to do that is we click on our original picture. We're going to go up here to select and then tonal range and select highlights. You can see it makes a nice selection. Then we go up again to select and say grow. We want to grow it a little bit, maybe 5 pixels. So it's a little bit bigger. And then we want to feather it so it has a soft edge. Pretty large soft edge actually, so I'm going to set this to, let's say, 25 pixels. So these numbers really depend on your image resolution that you use with the picture, so don't use these exact values, experiment a little bit with them. Okay, next thing you're going to do is just click on mask layer. So this is creating a mask. You can see it's a nice mask with all the highlights. We can hold Control D on our keyboard to deselect, and now what we can do, it even selected up here the umbrella of the dark areas. It's really nice, and we just we will click on our rain layer again and create a new adjustment layer for exposure. Pull that in again, and then pull your and then pull the mask onto that. That's important. So you can see inside of the rain layer, I will call this rain real quick, one moment. Rain. So inside of the rain layer, we have the exposure layer. Inside of the exposure layer, we have the mask layer. So now we double click on exposure. And you can see we can make it brighter around the areas where the light is. Of course, not that bright, just a little bit brighter, but in a way that we see that the light has an effect on the water that is falling down there, on the rain that's falling down there. And of course, you can always go back to your curve adjustment and adjust the amount of rain and the size of rain depending on your settings. Here you can see we can still create more rain in our picture or less rain. Let's make it a little bit more rainy. So there we go. We can set the exposure a little bit back. And then what I want to do, and it creates a lot more atmosphere in the picture, is I'm going to duplicate the rain and I'm going to rotate it a little bit. And this makes the picture much more believable and much more interesting. And we have to do some additional adjustments for that. So let's duplicate all of this. Duplicate, there we go. I will call this rain 2. Rain 02, there we go. And the first thing I want to do is pull out the mask from here. I will disable our exposure and then, or let's just pull out all of this. I will disable that and just pull it out. So I'm not changing the position. That's important because the position is dependent on the background of the picture and not on the rain. So there we go. And now that we have this, I can use this rain layer with the other settings inside. I will just zoom out a little bit so I can see where the borders are. And then holding the control key, I'm pulling out the edges. So you can see it pulls out in all directions at the same way, so it stays centered. And then we will rotate this a little bit so we have another angle where the rain is coming from. There we go. And so this already looks interesting. Let's zoom in. This already looks interesting, but we want to change this even more. So what I'm going to do is I zoom out again so I can see the borders. And what we're going to do is with our rain 2 layer selected, I'm going to click on the mesh warp tool. And you have these outlines, you can click on them and then you can bend them. And this will make the rain inside fall a little bit in a curve and make the path of the rain a bit more interesting. So like this, you can't really see what I'm doing because I need to see the outline. Sorry for that. But when I zoom in again, you can see that the rain now is a little bit curvy here. Let's hide the other rains. You can see this falls in a curved direction and mixes really well with the other rain. And to make this rain even more visible, what we're going to do is we're going to turn off the motion blur. This makes it a little bit too extreme, but I can go into the curves and make this rain less intense because this is basically just for the effect, just to look nice in my picture. And what it also does, what I find really nice, is that it creates some raindrops that are a little bit brighter than the other raindrops. So now I will pull back in the exposure adjustment and whoops, there we go. Activate it so it's getting brighter around the areas where the light is. You can see that this has a really nice atmospheric effect. Let's turn off the adjustment by both layers and you can see that it doesn't show up, the rain doesn't show up where the light is. And when I turn it on, it looks a lot more realistic because now I have these nice light streaks where the lights are in the picture. So this is basically how you create the rain for your picture. It's an easy way. You could, of course, use textures, but this is using noise that's inside of the program. So just tools of Affinity Photo. Play around with the settings, create different kind of rain moods. This is really experimental and artistic tool and a lot of fun to play with. So that was the tutorial for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you like my channel, I create 2 new tutorials every week. And if you want to support me even more, let's head over to Patreon where you can get my original files with all the layers. You can get feedback on your own creations and you can suggest topics to me that you want to see in the future. Thank you very much and see you in the next video. Bye.